then continue the questions. So already you have studied how to solve the pair of linear equation by substitution method. So I think you are all practicing the sums. Then we can do the remaining sums. So I gave one homework. Summatics will take forward. What is the homework? Solve 3x minus y equal to 0 and 9x minus 3y equal to 0. So I gave one homework already, but everyone did that one mistake. What is the equation I given? 3x minus y equal to 3 and 9x minus 3y equal to 9. So for this equation, you should solve by substitution method. So first you should consider equation number 1. When you consider equation number 1, what is equation number 1? 3x minus y equal to 3. Write any variable in terms of other. So I am writing x in terms of y. So how you can write 3x equal to minus 5. When you shift into the right side, you will get 3 plus 5. Then x equal to 3, when you shift into the right side, you will get 3 plus y divided by 3. After that, what you should do? Substitute x in. If you are considering equation number 1, substitution you should do in equation number 2. So substitute x in equation number 2. So first I consider the equation number 1. From that I am writing x in terms of y. Then that x we should substitute in equation number 2. So when you are substituting, what you will get? 9 into x is 3 plus y divided by 3 minus 3y equal to 9. 9 and 3 both are same, you can cancel it. 3 ones are 3 threes are. So when you continue, what you will get? 3 into 3 plus y minus 3y equal to 9. Next, what you should do? Open this bracket. 3 threes are 9. 3 into y, that is 3y minus 3y equal to 9. Here you can see same thing, one variable or number. Same thing if it is adding or and subtracting. Same thing if it is adding and subtracting means you can cancel it. So what will be the left hand side? Left hand side is 9, right hand side is 9. See here, you will get the left hand side equal to right hand side. So when you are solving by substitution method, sometimes you will get this condition. Left hand side equal to right hand side. If you are getting left hand side equal to right hand side, means this equation is true. If you are getting left hand side equal to right hand side, you will get the equation in true statement. So if the equation is true, means you can say the pair of linear equation is having coincident lines. Again I will say, if left hand side equal to right hand side, the equation is true, then you will get coincident lines. You have studied that for coincident lines means one line is coming over the other. So coincident lines, how many solutions will be there? Infinite number of solution. Next, means you will get left hand side is not equal to right hand side. Sometimes you will get left hand side is not equal to right hand side. That means bar. The equation is false. If left hand side is not equal to right hand side, equation is false. Then you will get parallel lines. Already I have explained for parallel lines. Total how many solution will be the for parallel lines? There will be no solution. If you are getting parallel lines, there will be no solutions. So like this sums. You want to identify which type of lines is that? So the total how many solutions will be there? That all you should understand. So we can do the remaining sums from the textbook. This one is the question from your textbook, second main question. That is, solve 2x plus 3y equal to 11 and 2x minus 4y equal to minus 24. Then, self addition is there and hence find the Volume of M four bits y equal to mx plus 3. So what is the question? They given that we should solve 2x plus 3y equal to 11 and 2x minus 4y equal to minus 24. After solving, what we should find? Value of M. And by using this condition, they are saying after solving the equations for this equation, y equal to mx plus 3, you should find the value of M. Okay, when you are solving, you will understand. So, you want to find the value of M for this y equal to mx plus 3. So, first of all, we want to solve the two equations. Substitution method we can use that. So first equation 2x plus 3y equal to 11. Consider equation number 1. Second equation 2x minus 4y equal to minus 24. Second one. First, what is the step we should do? Consider equation number 1. Consider equation number 1. What is equation number 1? 2x plus 3y equal to 11. Next, what you should do? Write x in terms of y. So here, first step. 3y you should shift to the right side. You will get 11 minus 3y. This is what I am writing. I am not writing x in terms of y. What is the reason? You can see equation 2 also, 2x is one of the term. So when you are substituting this 2x, you will get the value of y. Directly you can find the answer. Okay. So when I am writing x in terms of y, when you are substituting, you should get some values for y or x. So here you can see 2x equal to 11 minus 3y. When you are substituting in equation 2, you will get the value of y. So, here I am substituting 2x in equation number 2. So, when you are considering equation number 1, substitution you should do in equation number 2. What is equation number 2? 2x minus 4y equal to minus 24. When you are substituting this one, what you will get? Instead of writing 2x, what you should give the 11 minus 3y. So 11 minus 3y minus 4y equal to minus 24. What is minus 3y minus 4y? That is minus minus 2 to the power 7 is done. Minus 38. I am raising this question. So you will get minus 7y equal to minus 35. You can see both sides 2 negative signs. If you can see, then what will be remaining? 7y equal to